I'm going to show you an incredible camera tracking hack using PowerDirector. Follow me now. I have a clip of some people dancing on track one. I want to track them with the camera to create some movement. First thing that we need to do is go ahead and move the playhead to where we want to begin tracking. Once you get your playhead where you want it, you can do Control T on your keyboard and it will split that clip. Next, we'll play some text on the track two to use for the tracking. So I'm gonna go to the title room. I'm gonna go to default text. I'm gonna hold down my left mouse button and I'm gonna drag this right down to the playhead where I made that split on track two. I'll place my cursor at the end until I see two arrows pointed in the opposite direction. Hold down my left mouse button and drag it out or in to make sure that it matches the duration of the clip above it. Next, we want to make sure that our playhead is at the beginning of the clip. And then we'll go ahead and double left click on the title to open up the title designer. And we're going to go to the selected object. And we're gonna change the text to just the letter O. It'll be a capital O. And then we wanna place this capital O right over one of the dancers' faces. We're gonna use this guy on the right. We'll place our cursor over this text until we see crosshairs. Hold on our left mouse button and we'll drag it over his face. Now, if it isn't where you need it, you can use the arrows to make precise movements. And these are the arrows on your keyboard. Once you get it where you want it, you can go ahead and click on OK. And then what you want to do is lock this track down. So we're going to lock track two. We're doing that because we don't want the title to move anywhere. We want to make sure that this is always centered, which is going to be his face. And we're going to try to keep his face in this circle the whole time. In order to do that, we need to use keyframes. So we're going to left click on the clip above the title. And we're going to left click on keyframe. So we'll go to position and we're going to add a keyframe right here. This will lock it in right on his face. And then we can move our playhead a few frames forward to go ahead and get to another position where we think, hey, he's outside of the frame. And what we'll do at this point is we'll go ahead and left click here. It will drag this guy back into the center of the circle. Once again, you can use your arrow keys on your keyboard to move him over, up, down, whatever you need to do to get his face centered in that circle. Then you can move it forward a few more frames. And you keep doing that to keep his face centered. If it doesn't create a keyframe when you move his face, then you need to go ahead and click on the position keyframe and create another keyframe yourself. So you keep doing this until you get all the way to the end. If you scroll up the timeline and there's any segments where you feel like he's not in the circle, then you can go ahead and make whatever adjustments you need to make. And when you're done, you can go ahead and close out the keyframe window. And you can unlock the title track. You can left click on the title and you can delete it because you don't need it anymore. Now, if you move your playhead on here, as you can see, there's some black space showing at the sides, bottom, and different places. So we need to produce this entire timeline so that we can go ahead and save it as it is, bring it back into the editor and scale it up to get rid of the black lines. So we're going to move our playhead to the beginning. We're gonna click on produce. Go ahead and make sure that we have the appropriate produce settings. We'll go ahead and click on the location where we want to output the produced video to. And we'll click on save. And then we'll go ahead and click on start. Now we're going to click on back to edit. We're going to bring this clip into the timeline. Hold out our left mouse button and drag it down to track 2. We can go ahead and delete these previous clips here. I'm going to go ahead and hit the delete key on my keyboard. Now we'll double left click on this clip to open up the PIP designer so we can scale it up and position it how we need it. So you may need to go through and scrub the timeline to get an idea of where you're gonna see black. You see, I see black at the bottom here. See some black on the sides here. It's up to you what scale and what position you're gonna use. I'm gonna go ahead and type in some parameters here and see if it works out for me. And I'm gonna go ahead and click on okay. We can go ahead and play this back. Now, we back on track. If you need to track a moving object in your videos, you can learn how to do that right here. Don't forget to smash my face to subscribe, hit me up with your comments, and drop me a like down below.